Office Premises Number 741, a Whitehall Place, Number 741.
The Thanksgiving Mass of New Father Daniel Benlante in St. Dominic Church in Southington, Connecticut. Thánh lễ tạ ơn của Tân Linh Mục Daniel Benlante thuộc tu đoàn Thiền Sai Các Thánh Tông Đồ được cử hành tại nhà thờ giáo xứ Thánh Đa Minh tại thành phố Southington, tiểu bang Connecticut. Daniel Benlante, MSA, tại nhà thờ giáo xứ Thánh Đa Minh, St. Dominic Church in Southington, Connecticut.
Those of darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
so that we who believe that the Savior of the human race is with you in your glory may experience as he promised until the end of the world his abiding presence among us, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Yet, if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and he in us, that he has given us his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testified that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love. And whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
All the kids come on up.
Does anybody know why it's a special day? Why is it a special day? It's Mother's Day, right? Very good. How many of you did something nice for Mom this morning? Very good. How many of you get to it yet, but you're going to do something nice for Mom after Mass?
Very good.
I think we can do something very nice right now for all of our moms, our grandmothers, our godmothers, our aunts, all women who are like mothers for us in our life. Can we do something really nice for them? What do you think the nicest thing is we can do for somebody? Back there. No, oh, call you. Can't hear you. Pray for them. Amen. So let's say a prayer together right now. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You guys did a great job. Great. Wonderful. Wonderful. So it's Mother's Day. Yes. I'm going to say to the kids this morning, praying about it, thinking about it, and I brought my little statue here. Does anybody know who the two people are in the statue over there? Very good. Mary, our Blessed Mother, and Jesus. And Mary is holding Jesus. Right? Now that I hold my little cousin, I'm going to fumble them sometimes, so they don't let me hold babies in the family anymore. Long story. But she's holding Jesus out to say, hey, look, this is my beloved Son, my divine Son, my God's Son. And I want you all to hold him and embrace him and to love him like I do. Right? Mary said something very important in the Bible. She said about Jesus, do whatever he tells you. Do whatever he tells you. Now let me ask you, what does Jesus tell us to do? What do you think? What does Jesus tell us to do? What does he tell us to do?
He tells us to be nice to people, right?
Isn't that hard sometimes? Because not everybody's always nice to have, right? Sometimes I'm not always nice to have.
So we work out.
Yes, be nice to people.
Absolutely. Good advice for Mother's Day, right? Listen to your parents. Take out the trash the first time Mom asks, not the 15th. Very good. Pray for your parents. Absolutely. Pray, yes. Love your family. Very good. Sing his praises. Amen. Amen.
And you know, that's what Jesus says to us in the gospel. I got one more over here. Be kind to people. Yes. Jesus, he's talking today in the gospel. He's at the Last Supper, and he's praying. He's about to give Eucharist to his apostles. And we're going to have Eucharist here in a few minutes. And he's saying, look, I'm giving you the food you need to be strong. And you have breakfast.
Hello, Sister Lynn. This Thanksgiving Mass of a new father, then, am I say?
Who else are Jesus' disciples? God's disciples, that's right. Who else are Jesus' disciples?
Mary, she's number one, right? Saint Jacob, absolutely. All the saints are Jesus' disciples. Way in the back, who's sure?
The apostles? You guys listen to me, and you know them. All of us are Jesus' disciples. And he's sending all of us out to be kind, to be loving, to share the good news. Right? To share that Jesus loved us so much, he would die on a cross for us, he would rise from the dead for us, and always be with us. Give us his spirit so we never have to be afraid. So we can live as his disciples in joy and peace to help other people. So they too, hey, I'm a part of God's family too. Can we do that? Yeah, this week at school, I got
on Wednesday when you've long forgotten what I said? Do you maybe think to do that?
Can you remind your parents to do that? And all your relatives? How much does Jesus love you? 1,000,000,000%, absolutely. Never forget, he loves you this much. Amen? Now go share that with your families.
Barbara, Reverend George, and Christine, and parents, when we remember
Keep us one, and you, the Son and the Holy Spirit, are one. And with love, grant the prayers we make, for you are love, who are risen and ascended, Lord.
Thank you.
Thanksgiving Mass of Father Daniel. Just
it is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Thank you.
life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
May this sacrifice of all reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity our pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Christopher, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you gave for your own.
there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. What bestow con eniem, a ti Dios Padre omnipotente, en la unidad del Espíritu Santo, todo amor y toda gloria, por los siglos de los siglos.
Thank you.
Chào chị Hiếu.
Thank you.
Hear us, O God, our Savior, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries, there will be accomplished in the body of the whole church what has already come to pass through Christ, her head, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Proceeds from the sale will benefit local charities. Next weekend, we will be celebrating the Solemnity of Pentecost. Red is the liturgical color for the Solemnity, so if you can, please come wearing an article of red clothing. On Memorial Day, Monday, May 27th, Mass will be celebrated at 9 a.m. in St. Thomas Cemetery. Please bring a lawn chair with you. Coffee and snacks will be served afterward. If the weather does not cooperate, the Mass will be moved to Mary Our Queen Church. And following our closing hymn, there's a reception. So, come meet. Mothers, godmothers, grandmothers, aunts, mothers-to-be, expectant mothers, stepmothers, and anybody who's like a mother to somebody else, please stand for a moment. We have a blessing for you. Happy Mother's Day. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women, these mothers, godmothers, grandmothers, aunts, stepmothers, and mothers-to-be, that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. But the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Nobody likes a long-winded preacher, and who else who thanks so often. And I'm going to pull a page out of Father Hardy's book from yesterday. Please hold any applause until the very end. Thank you. And if I miss anyone, I'm going to apologize right at the beginning. I first need to give thanks to Almighty God, my Lord and Savior, your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for bringing me to this day. It was this profound humility that I stand before you, my hometown. And I asked one thing of God yesterday before ordination. I said, just please keep me faithful to my dying breath. And I asked you to please pray for me and for my brother, Father Hugh, who was ordained with me yesterday. He must stay faithful till the end of the service. I ended up here. So, it's a very good thing. today. All the servers, thank you for coming. You guys did an awesome job. Thank you so much. And Ronnie and Bobby, thank you so much for helping them out. My MSA community, my brothers, my family, it is so, I love the pieces come together. So if you come here today to my hometown and celebrate together, you took a chance on me, and I'm eternally grateful that you continue to live out in the heart of Mr. Moran's mission and vision to promote the company vocations of priesthood in all locations within the church. We continue to work after that day after day, bit by bit. And finally, one person who you have to recognize to stand out, she's here today. Because 20 years ago, on Sunday morning, I was minding my own business, praying the rosary before Mass, wasn't bothering anybody. And she came up to me and tapped me on the shoulder. And she said, you're going to teach confirmation for me next year, and you're going to be a wonderful priest one day. I said, sister, you're batting 500. I was wrong. So, Sister Marie Rocco Priori, my spiritual mother,
Amen.
bless you.